Well, the flu is peaking at epidemic levels in some parts of the U.S., and doctors are saying that this year's flu is highly infectious and that it can spread quickly. The Centers for Disease Control says that the virus is now in 41 states, with 29 states reporting high or severe levels of illness. One of the most vulnerable groups is kids. Pediatrician and blogger Dr. Melissa Arca, a.k.a. Dr. Mom, is joining us this morning. And your office started getting busy with this week.
Yes, definitely. And this week, I think, is just when we started seeing more and more cases of the flu. And I think where California now is probably seeing what the rest of the country has already been seeing for the last few weeks.
All right, so when somebody makes an appointment and they say, I got to get in, what's the barometer of when you think they do need to make that appointment?
Well, so typically I ask parents what the symptoms are. I mean, the flu looks like this. The fever suddenly comes on. The child was well the day before and suddenly spikes a high fever, 103, 104, 105, really high fevers, which really scares the parents. But that's kind of how the flu starts. And then they get body aches, they're fatigued. They don't want to eat. They start with the cough and sore throat. Those are all typical things for the flu, and we do expect the fever to peak on day three and start to come down, and flu symptoms typically last for about a week.
Okay, what if you get to like day three, day four, and it doesn't seem like it's really going down? Is that then when you need to make that appointment?
I definitely would. Just have them checked out, make sure there's no other secondary infections, because those are the complications of the flu that can really cause problems
for
children.
So is that what gets a kid in the hospital?
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah, so they can get pneumonia, bronchitis, trouble breathing, all those things which are secondary complications of the flu. Those are the things we want to worry about and rule out in any child that is
sick. So what can you actually do once you're pretty sure that a kid does have the flu? What do you actually do for them? Do you give them a medication, or are you supposed to wait this thing out?
So the flu is a virus, the influenza virus, and so antibiotics don't help. The best thing are fluids, rest, and making sure that your child is comfortable drinking and all those things. There is an antiviral medication that you can use, typically named Tamiflu, mm-hmm. which is really reserved for patients who are either immunocompromised, children less than two, who are at the highest risk of complications from
the flu.
All
right, we've got a Facebook question that came in today from Crystal Daniel, who says, other than the obvious disinfecting, how can you prevent the flu from making a second round at your house?
Exactly, a second round, yeah, passing it on to each other.
Exactly.
Well, number one, obviously, is getting the flu vaccine, because we know that it's an excellent match this year, so that's really important. If you haven't done it yet, it takes 2 weeks to develop immunity, so now's the time to get it, especially now in California. But vigorous and vigilant hand washing, making sure that if there is somebody sick, you can kind of quarantine them to a certain part of the house.
Does that work in a family?
It can.
I mean, it's better than nothing, I guess.
I mean, it's worth a try. Definitely having everyone cough and sneeze into the crook of their elbow. If keeping kids and adults home from school and work if they are sick, and those are really getting lots of rest, eating plenty, you know, eating well, exercising, all those things are going to keep your immune system up.
All right. Thank you, Dr. Mom. We appreciate it. For more cold and flu tips, don't forget to check out Dr. Mom's blog, and we do have a link on our website, kcra.com. Just click under the On TV tab.